Well, after the events of yesterday, I'm really starting to think this canning's got me beat. Doing the tyring late yesterday afternoon was almost the last straw. I was ready just to set up camp here and stay. I didn't put the awning up last night, which was a bad move because it rained overnight. Now I've got a soaking wet swag as well. The prospects for solar today aren't looking real flash either. So I'm thinking I'm gonna continue on. I've got one spare left. I've got the rest of my party probably a couple of days away to well six. It's about 120 kilometres, and I suspect that's going to be another 4 hours of slow slug. I'm just going to have to be real careful with tyres. Not that I wasn't careful before, but yeah, winging a prayer. Hopefully we get to well six. Supposedly a nice campground with water, so it should be somewhere you could hole up for a couple of days pretty easy. But yeah, we'll see how we go. So I'll plug on, and hopefully this afternoon, maybe early this afternoon, I'll be at Pierre Springs, well six. Maybe the sun might come out and get swagged right around as well. Deep inside his temple, he knows how to surf her. Getting away with it all, mister. Getting away with it all, mister. That's the living. Of slow going creek crossings in here. Makes a change from rocks and corrugations anyway. Slowly pick your line. It's all pretty easy really. Don't speak too soon, famous last words as they say. Following the Freer Range generally eastward for a little bit, we've come into the start of the range and then just sort of slowly meandering our way up to the rest of it. Just crested a rise and into view has come the Inglebong Hills, and very picturesque it is too. Seeing I'm up high, I'm going to give out a call and see if we can talk to my party. Team Steve and Harry, how do you read? Over.
Loud and clear, mate, can you hear us?
Roger, mate, I'm about 12 kilometres out. I've just climbed a crest and come to a stand. I thought I might be able to get you from here. Over.
Yeah, Roger, mate, I've just deployed the awning and about to crack me first ear.
Roger, so you're staying there the night, are you?
Roger that.
Well, you just screwed my plans of a nice quiet night in and a lay day tomorrow, you bugger.
Maybe we'll have a headache in the morning, mate.
Sounds good. I've got to get a swag rolled out pretty quick when I get in, because I didn't deploy an awning last night and I got a bit wet.
The rain where you were, did it?
Yeah, early hours of the morning, we had a few showers come in and the swag got wet. But listen, I'll keep pushing on, about 12 k's, shouldn't be far away, and you better let Brenda know that I've got some supplies.
Oh, mate, she's rubbing her hands in anticipation. All right, mate, we'll see you in half an hour, mate.
The gums of well six have just come into view. Target is very nigh, and just as I'm approaching, the sun decides to poke its head out. There they are. Lights are blazing. Into town we go. Wow, it is a magic looking spot. And there we have it, a splendid night at a magnificent little camp place, Pierre Springs, reunited with the party, and now I get to travel the six worlds back to Wiluna, the joy of it all. In all its splendid colour, and I'll go find somewhere to park so I can see what we can do with this tank before it bloody decides to sit on the ground and not play the game.
Are driving Saturday afternoon, just pass me by, and I'm just savoring familiar sights. We shared some history, this town and I. Stop that long forgotten feeling of her. Time to book a room to stay tonight. Number one is to find some friends to say you're doing well. After all this time, you boys look just the same. Number two is the happy hour at one of two hotels. Settle in to play, do you remember so and so? Never say a name. Oh, the flame trees will blind the weary driver, and there's nothing else could set fire to this town. There's no change there. There's no pace, everything within its place just makes it harder to believe that she won't be around. But oh, who needs that sentimental bullshit anyway? More than just a memory to make me cry, and I'm happy just to sit at a table with old friends and see which one of us can tell the biggest lies. And there's a girl just for